Hey, what's up? This is DeMortez. It's Thursday, June 28th, 2012, and good morning to you if you're listening to me and it's morning. If it's afternoon, good afternoon to you. And if you waited till night, good evening. Remember, I'm your brother, cousin, uncle, best friend, co-worker, castmate, neighbor, everything wrapped up into one. And this is the DeMortez Entertainment News Snippet, so I got two snippets for you to get you started for the morning. Diana Ross ignoring Tyler Perry? Yeah, and Tyler's kind of upset about it. I'll tell you about that. And gospel artist James Fortune releases a statement. Yeah, some child abuse allegations were brought against him. And I got some music for you as well, just a little bit. So sit back for about 5 minutes. Okay, so get it started with James Fortune. Now, who is James Fortune? James Fortune is like one of the biggest names in gospel music right now. He's kind of like a Kirk Franklin. He doesn't really sing, but he has background singers that can really sing good. I mean, really sing their butt off. His biggest hit thus far was Still Able, and I'll play a little bit of it for you. You may remember this song.
About to give up.
God reminded me, that he's still able.
But it's not easy because
sometimes it seems,
oh God,
there's no.
Yeah, very powerful, anointed song. Great artist, great lyrics. But here's what's going on with Mr. Fortune, okay? In 2001, he allegedly abused his stepson, who was 4 at the time. Reports are saying that Mr. Fortune whipped the child naked with a switch and then held the child down in scalding water, okay? So the child had to be flown to Shriners Burn Hospital, where he remained for 63 days with second and third degree burns over 40% of his body. Now, the child is 15, okay, and he has to undergo skin grafts. And the child's biological father is suing James Fortune and his wife for $5 million to cover plastic surgery costs. Well, Mr. Fortune has released a statement, and here's what he said. I recently became aware of a civil suit pending against my wife, Cheryl, and I for an incident that occurred in 2001 involving my stepson. There was a criminal investigation, and all matters were resolved in 2003. Since that time, my family and I, including my stepson, have continued with family traditions and always provide a loving family environment. We are shocked by this lawsuit, but understand people are free to use the court system to pursue claims whether they contain merit or baseless matters. We are confident through the process. If it proceeds to a judge or jury, the ultimate decision maker will render a decision that is favorable to the circumstances and timing surrounding this situation. We believe in our American justice system and know it will work for us as it has for millions of other Americans. Wow. And it has worked for a lot, but for a lot, it has not. So I'll definitely keep you informed on that, what happens in that situation. Diana Ross ignoring Tyler Perry? Apparently, Tyler Perry wants to work with Diana Ross, but Ms. Ross is not having it. Perry told Essence.com while promoting his latest movie, Madea's Witness Protection, which hits theaters on tomorrow, that Diana Ross has been ignoring him for years. He also said that she's the only person that he's dreamed of working with that will not return his phone calls. Tyler then recalled a conversation he had with Diana back in the day, and she said no, and that was it. Diana Ross may be ignoring Tyler Perry, but he does get to work with two childhood idols. That's Marla Gibbs, you know, she was Florence in The Jefferson, and John Amos. Yeah, good old James from Good Times, and he's really excited about that. You know, but Tyler, don't take Diana so seriously. You know, she may be busy. You know, Diana Ross is a diva, and there's a song for every situation. Tyler.
Do you know? Where you going to? Do you like the things that life has shown?
Now there's a remix to this, and I want to sing
where
it now.
Going to?
It goes like this.
Do you know
she's ignoring you? Do you know that Diana Ross doesn't want to be in your movie or your TV show? I mean, just get over it. I mean, maybe she's busy. Maybe she's walking in a spider web.
I'm walking in a spider web. Leave a message and I'll call you back.
Yeah, just leave a message, Tyler, and call her back. Call her Miss Ross, and then maybe she'll answer. Okay, well, that's it for the DeMartez Entertainment News snippet for today. Remember to follow me on Twitter at D_Martez Show. I'll keep you in the loop on all entertainment news and good stuff. And on Facebook, like my Facebook fan page, that's DeMartez. Okay, so tell a family member, tell a friend, tell everybody to tune in. I appreciate you listening. I'm going to leave you with the number one song in the country. Yeah, another phone call song, Call Me Maybe. Yeah, maybe Diana will call Tyler. And this is by Carly Rae Jepsen. So I'm going to sign out for now, but I'll holla at you on tomorrow. And remember, DeMartez, I love you listening.
Hey.